Science through the ages, antiquity to Renaissance. Images courtesy of Wikimedia Commons and Google Images. Narrated by Dylan Whaley. The layout of this project will be as follows. We will start from the earliest ages of scientific progress from 230 BC and then go up until Renaissance times, also known as the Enlightenment. Starting in the field of medicine, the earliest known use of tools for surgery were used by Hippocrates and his followers. His contributions to science also include those of recording down diseases on a pandemic, endemic, and systemic scale. Other contributions include those of knowledge of cleanliness, sterilization, and as well as a naturalistic explanation for how diseases occurred and sickness came to be. Moving on to the fields of mathematics, Euclid, also known as the father of geometry, helped pave the way for many contributions to the fields of architecture, design, mathematics, and a numerous amount of other implementations from that point onwards. Also amongst these are insights into architecture that have previously gone overlooked and was also responsible for figuring out the strength of the column. Moving on to a related field, Socrates, also known as the father of physics, managed to figure out the strength of the pulley, the column, as well as implementations of the dome, the arch, and new insights into how one could include these in architectural designs. Gluing all of these progresses together, we have the invention of cement. Cement, without rebar or free support, became one of the primary ways of building structures and was responsible for some of the best looking and still standing structures that we still see today. These include the arch, sculptures that still stand in temples, as well as bathhouses from those times that are still in existence. Also, aqueducts that stood in Rome now still stand today and can be seen anytime anyone ever visits those cities. Unfortunately, by 270 AD, Christianity, as well as a number of other forces such as invading empires, Huns, barbarians, etc., had been splintering the Roman Empire apart, and then, by 500, Rome had fallen. This had followed a number of other major losses of knowledge, such as the burning of the Library of Alexandria, but undoubtedly the fall of Rome is one of the biggest intellectual withdrawals that we've suffered as a species in almost all of history. This gave rise to a splintered kingdom that centered around old Roman values, but openly embraced Christianity despite the loss of all of their previous intellectual advancements. Soon, though, things began to collapse further, the Byzantine Empire fell, and eventually most of the scientific knowledge in the world migrated to the Middle East. Scientific advancement continued in the Middle East for another multiple hundred years, until eventually the Middle East itself became a hotbed of turmoil as the Mohammedans came to power, and eventually the Quran became the main source of knowledge. The eventual belief that the Quran, as their holy book, was the main source of knowledge and was all that was ever needed led to the collapse of the Middle East, and eventually all of the knowledge in the world was left in Latin scripts that everyone was growing distant from. As of 1000 BC, all of the scripts that were left on scientific knowledge in the world were in the hands of the church, who, although they did a great job in preserving that which needed to be preserved, anything that opposed church values was burned and could not be rediscovered later in history. That knowledge which survived was rediscovered later when Latin became a language that was more readily available and was more easily translatable. This has been my project, and thank you for watching.